gamers, and welcome to another First Impressions video by me, Leo. And yeah, today we're gonna look at something amazing. Well, not really that amazing, but something that you'll probably recognize and probably are already playing at this time. So what's the purpose of this video? Well, I've been asked, like, I've done videos for Battlefield 3, Tribes Ascend, Trine 2, blah blah blah, there's so many things. And why I haven't actually covered on a MOBA game called Dota 2? That's right. So today I'm actually going to do that. So let's turn up this volume a little bit. That's still too loud. And as you can hear, a game is actually underway. And right now, I'm playing a replay of a game that I played earlier on.
First blood, and may the all-knowing one bear witness.
Holy shit. Omni Knight. Yep, that was the Omni Knight. Yeah, before we go into the game, we're gonna look at the interface, the lobby. As you can see, yeah, this is it. You have your active regions, and there's US West, US East, Europe, Southeast Asia, and China. Obviously, we are in Malaysia, so we'll be playing in SEA. Okay? So the way it works is just click on it, which one's active, and you play, alright? It's not smart to select all of them active. You get like really crappy servers and you don't want that. I get like about 90 ping from a server in Singapore or something, so I suspect that the server's in Singapore. It's really good. I have to agree that it has been improved from HON. The game is actually a lot similar to HON in all respects, in terms of its mechanics and so forth, but then again, it's also a direct copy of Dota 1. But yeah, this is the Source Engine's version of Dota, and it's amazing. I'm not going to talk anymore about the interface. Basically, you can see for yourself, here are the top live matches. They're currently playing all over the world. My friends list, the channel list, my profile. As you can see, I have 33 wins and 22 losses. Yep, pretty amazing. Okay, let's jump into the game. Okay, so right now we're watching a replay of a game I played back in, I think, February 4th. Quite recent. There's nothing special about this game except that I remember owning a silencer. Yeah, this is me. Silencer. So if I click on this, it's not gonna jump directly to my particular hero. The reason is because I'm actually using something called Directed. It's a camera view. There's several of them. Free camera, player's perspective, hero chase, etc. So, yeah, these actually have different styles of camera movements. Director actually is controlled by AI, the game has. I have to say, it's pretty good. And so far, I have to say, the only thing that is lacking from that particular camera is that it doesn't actually pick up certain small things. Like, for example, if there's two major ganks going on, if you look at the bottom left, I see, like, the overall map. Let's say there's like two major ganks going on. It will have to decide between the two. So sometimes it's not accurate. It doesn't actually tell you which one it is. But by far, to say, out of 100, it gets a 99% out of that. It's pretty damn accurate at what it picks up. So there's probably like a certain way it calculates which one is more intense, which encounter, which battle, which small skirmishes are actually extremely important. But yeah, Dota is a really fast-paced game. It's hard to actually, even for me, I mean, honestly saying, it's even hard for myself to get, what the hell is this guy doing? Oh my god. Honor your sacrifice. Wow. Yeah, that was my teammate. Amazing. I'm glad that the director mode picked that up. Oh yeah, anyways, going back, I have to say, like, honestly speaking, even for myself, I can't pick up all the action across the map, because there's just too many things going on. Like just now, you just saw Ricky die, and before that you saw the Omni Knight commit suicide. I couldn't have caught all that at one go. So yeah, this is actually a lot better than some people who use Observer mode and do a really bad job at capturing the action. So yeah, good job on Val for doing that. Good job on Ice Frog for stressing that issue. Yeah, it's really easy to see how this is gonna be a extremely e-sporty style of game, and yeah, Valve has definitely done a great job in doing that. Audio channel, I suspect that in live gameplay you could hear people talking. voice chat. Unfortunately, in replays, you cannot actually download that, so it's really unfortunate you cannot hear any of the chatter that goes on between the two teams. Fog of War, of course, it's basic stuff like Dire or Radiant. Alright, let's talk about the factions. Well, not really factions, but the two sides. Instead of the Sentinels and the Scourge from Dota 1, you have something called the Radiant and the Dire. Dire being these guys, the evil-looking ones, and Radiant being the guys who look like Krees. Yep, here we are. The really bullshit chatter that you find in every single Dota game. The people who cry and scream and speak really bad English when they argue. Yeah, you cannot actually have a Dota game without these people. You just have to have them. It's awesome. Okay, let's switch to free camera and let's look around the map a little bit. If I can actually do that. Alright, so here we have Sniper. He's a really ugly looking troll of a guy. Really annoying. Has a lot of range to what you can find from a sniper. Here are his skills, okay? So you have Scattershot, which is called Shrapnel. Headshot, which is that little stun thing. And I think he's gonna die here. Oh! Major save by Rikimaru. But unfortunately, it doesn't help him that much. And is Ricky gonna die here? Oh, it's really close. No, he's not. Someone's coming in to save his butt. And it looks like it's me. Holy shit. Come in and save his butt. Get a kill for Rikimaru. Come on. Blink strike, baby. That's it. That's me. Oh, I'm gonna get this kill. Am I? Yeah, I'm gonna get this kill. I welcome. Oh, yeah. Feel good about that. Oh, yes. Yeah, as you can see, the game gets really intense, and I didn't plan for that. I didn't plan for that nice little counter gank right there. So good job on me, and good job on Rikimaru. Three-man gank turned into a reversal. How awesome was that? Yeah, anyways, going back to the game. Skills are pretty much the same. You have your Curse of Silence with the silencer, and then that Glaive of Wisdom, and then Last Word, okay? If you played Dota 1, you recognize all these spells. And then you have the ultimate, which is a Global Silence. The way the buttons work this time is they use the QWER layout, which is pretty much standard now for most MOBA-style games. I actually don't mind it. You can actually switch and customize your controls, but we're not going to go through that today because it's kind of pointless. Let's look at this action. Oh! He gets amplified damage cast on top of him, so no one's chasing him right now. However, he is still revealed to the map, so what is Sniper gonna do? Who knows? Go back to me. I'm not doing much right now. I'm just defending this tower, not really concentrating on harassing or fighting anyone. Reason is because I really just want to get as much cash as possible, build my Orchid. Orchid being the staff that costs, that actually allows you to cast silence again on somebody, an external item. So yeah, here are the items that I have currently. Pretty standard. Then you have the shop. The thing I like about this is that it shows you, if you hover over the shop button, it has the reliable goal, unreliable goal, and current buyback costs. These are really basic stuff. Unreliable goal, I think it's... I can't really understand what that is. I thought it was, you know, the goal you're gonna lose when you die. But it doesn't actually seem to be that. I think it is. Is it? Nope, doesn't seem like it. I have no idea what that means till today, so if someone actually knows, please leave a comment in my description below the video. Explain to me what that is. Buyback cost, of course, is your cost of respawn if you choose to buy yourself back. Not really a big deal. But lately, I've been seeing a lot of people doing buybacks just because they can. It's really annoying to watch. Here you can see the sniper being annoying. It's gonna harass them from long range. Yeah, full level on take aim, which has increased his range overall. Pretty awesome. Alright, let's switch over to the top. Thank you. Looks like it's a gank going on over here. I'm here right now, as you can see. Nothing much going on. You know, it looks like they're gonna do a gank on us, but who knows. He's got haste on, so... Oh shit! cast it on the invoker, I come in, take the kill. Oh no, I didn't get the kill. Did I get the kill? Split among, I guess it's like assist. I don't know, I think I got the kill. Can't really say, so bad. Okay, let's talk about the creeps. As you can see, you have the creeps here, standard stuff, centaurs, you can farm. You have all the other stuff. Camps are pretty much the same. You have the green camps and the orange camps, but they don't come out orange yet. I don't know why. It's pretty odd. And then you have the red camps, which is down here in the bottom here. Dragons. And then you have Roshan, which is here. Big ass Roshan. So right now, it's a counter gank. I come in, cast Curse of the... Curse of what? Curse of Silence. And I get a kill. I believe. Did I get a kill? I think I got a kill. No, I didn't. Ricky Maurer got a kill. Alright. I got an assist. And 4 top. So, we're not gonna actually fight these guys because we are pretty much outnumbered at this point. Going back to bottom, Invoker. Not really doing anything. I have no idea what the hell he's up there, down there for. He's not even farming. He's just standing there. Not even shopping. Oh, speaking about that, let's click on Player's Perspective. This mode I like. If there's anything about training somebody and telling them how to play a game, this is the best mode to watch it from. The reason is because it gives you access to see what that person is doing. Right now I'm looking at Rikimaru's perspective. You can see him clicking everywhere on the map. That's not my mouse, that's his mouse. So yeah, this is me circling his mouse, putting a box on it. So you can see how he plays and how he maneuvers around the map, where his camera is, what he's looking at. And, you know, from a commentary perspective, this is the best mode to watch in. It's like watching an F1 driver, you know, from their point of view, you know, on the actual track, you know, going around everything, and you just feel, well, not feel, but you get to see what they're looking at. And I like that. Alright, so looks like a failed gank over here. Yep, seems like a failed gang. I cast Silence so they can get away. I don't know why the Omni Knight decided to go back in there. Me being in the middle, I couldn't really help them. I was hoping they can actually get away. It seems like they're gonna get away. Yeah, Rikimaru just barely getting away right there. I think the Evoker is gonna get a punch in the face. Yep, he is. Let's click on the Evoker and see what happens next. So Evoker now, casting like crazy. You can see the buttons he's pressing. And he takes a dive. Sniper is still up. He's running for his life, he dies as well. So yeah, everyone here is basically crowded in and trying to kill everyone else. Omni Knight taking a severe punch in the face by Juggernaut, or slash in the face in this case. Rikimaru probably gonna wipe this whole entire team. Yep, he's gonna do it. Oh wow. Amazing crap right here. Triple kill by Rikimaru. Omni Knight chasing after the Juggernaut. Juggernaut obviously having boots of speed. Believe. Let's see. Nope, he's got face boots. So yeah, it's really fast with face boots. No way we can catch him. I don't think I have. Yep, I have only power treads. Not really gonna do much against that. Let's click on the Weaver. Weaver, not so much weapons at this point. He's got like utilities, but yeah, it's pretty good. I don't know why I'm casting the game right now. I'm not supposed to cast the game. I'm supposed to talk to you about the game. So let's go back to the game. God damn it. Okay. Free mode. Okay. Yeah, you can actually see what they buy as well, which is really awesome. So yeah, this is back to the game. Overall, the way it's done, the graphic style, the art style, it's pretty amazing. I have no complaints about it. Even though you can see like trees look really fake. It looks like plastic trees that had leaves stuck to them with super glue. So yeah, it kind of looks like that, but honestly speaking, you don't really care about that. You know, when you break trees, when you destroy trees, like they pop out like mushrooms. Pretty amazing. And I like that artsy style. When heroes get to a certain point of damage, for example, I think the Omni Knight does this. If he reaches around, say, 300 or 200 or less HP and he's still alive, he'll start to stagger. It doesn't reduce his speed, it just makes him look like he's gonna die, you know, it looks really weak. So it's an animation that indicates that this guy is low on HP, you better kill him if you want to kill. Or you better run your ass out of there if you actually want to survive. Pretty good stuff. There's other small, like, features that I like. For example, certain places around the map, you get to see, like, sort of like little jungle animals running around. I can't really see from the fog, but let me see what I can find one somewhere in the, along the map. Like, in the water, you can see... Oh, wait. Yeah, you see that? Frog and little butterflies. All these small, tiny little things. You can see dragonflies over here. I think there's fishes as well. Oh, there's also regeneration runes and stuff like that. If a hero was to pick that up, you can hear him shout, "Regeneration!" in his voice. And that's pretty awesome. Aesthetically, this game looks really pretty. I have no complaints. It's, maybe it has the same clipping problem that every single MOBA game has. But yeah, minor things like that, not so much. Let's see the fish. Nope. Nope, can't see fish anywhere. He's gonna pick up the regeneration, and we can hear him say, "Regeneration!" Oh my god, I just walked past the regeneration rune. Okay, I guess my team isn't the dumbest team in the world. Yep, every single Dota game, you hear someone complain that their team is the dumbest team in the world. Which is quite true sometimes, honestly. Okay, going back to towers. Towers are pretty decent. They're not as heavily damaged. They're not as heavily... painful as in League of Legends, and not as heavily pathetic as in HON. So, honestly speaking, they do a decent job, and they're there for their sole purpose, to stop you from pushing onwards. like any other MOBA game, ganking, teamwork, you know, really, really is expressed in this game. So, there's no way to win a game by yourself. There's just no way. You have to work as a team, you know, finish it as a team. But if you want to carry it, there is an opportunity to carry. But overall, like, it's a team effort, and you just have to figure out a way to work together. Like what we did. We honestly, by right, shouldn't have won this game. We just, for some stupid reason, we got a lot stronger at the end. I was overly fed, but the problem was I was a support. I couldn't really do much in terms of pushing or defending. And then it just became really stressful after that. But yeah, like this game, it's awesome. If you want to watch the replay and you're interested in seeing what happens at the end, just message me on Facebook or Steam. My username being Leo3010, you can add me. If you want to be my friend, or be my friend, people. if you want to add me, you can do so, just to talk and, you know, chat about gaming stuff. You can look me up on the Malaysian Gamer Steam group as well. I will be on there 24/7 if I can. If I'm not on there, you can just leave a message and get back to me. I will reply that message to you. All right. Yeah, this is Dota 2, ladies and gentlemen. If you haven't actually played this yet, I suggest you get somebody, shake them, and force them to give you a access code for the beta. Alright, this has been me, Leo, and this has been another First Play video. Thank you very much. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Kids up! Curse you! Great fear, not heresy. I join.